facts about our digestive system. We just took a ride down the alimentary canal, but there may be some questions regarding digestion that we may have missed, and you may be curious about it. Let's take a look at some of these. First question, what causes an ulcer? Is it really because of stress? Our stomach lining is covered with mucus-secreting cells. Mucus protects the stomach against the highly acidic hydrochloric acid and harsh action of a protein-digesting enzyme called pepsin. Sometimes, however, the walls of the stomach are exposed to the enzyme and acid, causing a sore in that area. This sore is referred to as an ulcer. It was previously thought that ulcers were caused by over-secretion of digestive juices, stress, and eating spicy food. This is because stomach ulcers were pretty common in Asians, who are famous for eating food rich in spices. However, it turns out that the basis for most ulcers is none of the above, but something so small that we will have to go to the microscopic level to reach for the answer. Yes, the answer is bacteria. It is an infectious bacterium called Helicobacter pylori, which has the remarkable ability to live in the highly acidic environment of the stomach. Damage to the stomach lining initiated by the bacterial infection is made worse by hydrochloric acid and pepsin. H. pylori is still a widely researched topic, as it is believed that acid reflux and ulcers both are caused by this bacteria, and both can be treated by taking an antibiotic. Next question. What is lactose intolerance? Lactose intolerance is becoming increasingly common globally, and is thought to affect 75% of the world's population. These people start experiencing digestive disorders when they take in dairy products. This is because people stop producing the enzyme lactase, and thereafter have difficulty digesting lactose, which is a type of sugar in the milk. Lactose is a disaccharide and cannot be absorbed without being broken down into its constituent monosaccharides, glucose and galactose. If a considerably large amount of lactose remains unabsorbed and passes into the large intestine, its metabolism by bacteria in the large intestine causes abdominal cramps, gas, and diarrhea. It can be caused because of genetic abnormalities and may start as early as the age of 2. This is referred to as primary lactose intolerance. Secondary lactose intolerance is caused at a later age, after the person develops a disease that stops the production of lactase. Next, what causes you to release gas? Ever wondered what causes us to release gas? And why do we release more gas after eating certain foods? The answers here are intestinal bacteria. These bacteria process certain carbohydrates that our stomach and small intestines cannot, and produce gases such as methane and hydrogen sulfide as byproducts of their largely anaerobic metabolism. The gases are then released through the anus. This is why sometimes the gas smells so gross. An example of this is when we eat beans. A large percentage of the mass of feces consists of the cell wall of dead intestinal bacteria that sacrifice their lives after digesting our food for us. Talk about silent warriors. And the final question, is E. coli always the bad guy? A huge amount of populations of bacteria live within the human colon. One of the resident species is none other than the bacteria celebrity, as it always remains in the public eye. The Escherichia coli, a bacterium popular among not only researchers in biochemistry, genetics, and molecular biology, but also laymen, as some of the most common disease outbreaks is caused by it. Did you know that E. coli lives on matters that are indigestible to humans? And did you know that the bacteria produce some beneficial products, such as vitamin K and biotin, which we humans cannot otherwise synthesize? Excessive or prolonged intake of antibiotics, especially broad-spectrum antibiotics, can lead to vitamin deficiency. This is because, in addition to killing disease-causing organisms that they are intended for, they also kill the normal microflora bacteria, which produce vitamins for us.